Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So in this video we will be talking about our daily current affair MCQs based series. So in which what we do, we daily discuss 10 MCQs from your current affairs perspective. So today is 29th August. So let's see what are the MCQs of today. So the first question is, consider the following statements related to Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana. First, it aims to provide free LPG connections to all the households. Second, the scheme is implemented by Ministry of Consumer Affairs. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. So the answer is neither one nor two, because this friend, Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana, is not provided to is not available to all the households. It is basically to provide free LPG connections to those who are below poverty line as per the socio-economic caste census data of 2011. And the scheme is not implemented by Ministry of Corporate Affairs, rather it is implemented by Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas. So the answer is D, that is neither one nor two. So basically this scheme is to provide LPG connection to poor households. So what it does, it provides rupees 1600 assistance in getting this LPG connection. So basically what the eligible households do, they buy the connection as well as that chulla, or we can say that gas connection, entire we can say entire infrastructure, we can say better it could be called the entire setup that is required. So that will be that is bought by the poor household, but the household gets reimbursement in the form of subsidy in their bank account. So rupees 1600 is provided by center. So identification is based on eligible households that are identified in consultation with state and union territories, and the scheme is implemented by Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas. So what are the key objectives? Basically to empower women and to protect their health and reduce health hazards with cooking based on fossil fuel, reducing the number of deaths in India due to unclean cooking fuel, and also preventing young children from significant number of acute respiratory illnesses that are caused by indoor air pollution by burning of the fossil fuel. Next is, second, child well-being index is released by A, National Family Health Survey, B, Niti Aayog, C, World Vision India, D, none of the above. So friends, the answer is C, World Vision India. So basically it is an NGO that releases this child well-being index. So it releases it in association with the research institute IFMR lead. So index is basically to judge that child well-being in terms of their health, in terms of their education, and in terms of the nutrition available to them, and sanitation and child protection. So various dimensions include healthy individual development. So in development comes your nutrition, health, education, and then sanitation, and also positive relations and protective context. So sanitation and child protection is also there. So this next is your it's one of the primary objective is to garner the attention to the under research theme of child well-being in India and inspire further academic and policy conversations on related issues. So key findings are that Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Himachal Pradesh and Puducherry topped the charts. Meghalaya, Jharkhand and Madhya Pradesh featured at the bottom. The data shows that even states that are performing best in overall child well-being are not doing so well in indicators of health. Now let's move on to the third question. Third question is, consider the following statements related to Pradhan Mantri Bharatiya Jan Aushadhi scheme. First, it aims to provide generic medicines at affordable prices to masses. Second, it is implemented by Bureau of Pharma PSUs of India. So which of the above statements is correct? A, one only. B, second only. C, both one and two. D, neither one nor two. So the solution is C, that is both 1 and 2. So it basically it is a scheme which aims to provide generic medicines at affordable prices to masses, and it is implemented by Bureau of Pharma PSUs of India, which is itself under Department of Pharmaceuticals, Government of India. So it is basically to provide generic medicines to masses so that they can get these medicines at affordable cost, and the out-of-pocket expenditure on medicine can be reduced. So this is about the scheme. Salient features are to reduce the out-of-pocket expenditure on medicines. So generic medicine is that medicine which is unbranded, but it is equally safe and having the same efficacy as that of branded medicines in terms of the therapeutic value. So next is your fourth question is, consider the following statements related to global environment facility. First, it is established under UNFCCC. Second, it provides investment in the developing and poor countries for the green developmental projects. So we have to choose that which of the above statements are correct. So let me tell you friends that both of these statements are incorrect, because it is not established under UNFCCC. Because basically it is the Global Environment Facility was set up as a financial organization under World Bank in 1991, but later on in 1992 it was set up as an independent financial organization. So it basically but now the World Bank just acts as the trustee of this Global Environment Facility Fund. So it is not established under UNFCCC, and it doesn't provide investment in developing and poor countries. It is not that, but it provides funds relating to specific conventions. For example, convention on Stockholm Convention on Persistent Organic Pollutants and lot of others also. So the answer is neither one nor two. So D is the answer. So basically it was established as a fund under World Bank in 1991, but in 1992 it was restructured and moved out of World Bank system to become a permanent separate institution. Since 1994, the World Bank has served as a trustee of the GE Trust Fund, GEF Trust Fund, and also then it serves as the financial mechanism under UNFCCC, UN Convention on Biological Diversity, and Stockholm Convention on Persistent Organic Pollutants, and United Nations Convention to Combat Desertification, and Minamata Convention on Mercury. So basically, who is the implementing agency? United Nations Development Program is the implementing agency. So students also get confused about who is implementing it, that is World Bank or UNDP. So please ensure that you know it, that UNDP is the implementing agency for this. So it is not linked to Montreal Protocol on substances that deplete the ozone layer, but it supports implementation of protocol in countries with economies in transition. Now let's move on to the next question. Next is fifth question, and we have to consider certain statements about Energy Efficiency Services Limited. So we have to consider that which of the following schemes is implemented by this Energy Efficiency Services Limited. One, Ujla. Second, Atal Jyoti Yojana. Third, Building Energy Efficiency Program. Fourth, Efficient Super Efficient AC Programs program. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. So the answer is 1, 2, 3, 4, all are correct. So because Ujla is also there, Atal Jyoti Yojana, that is street lighting program, or Building Energy Efficiency program, and also and Super Efficient AC program, all are implemented under this Energy Efficiency Services Limited, which is a joint venture of four national public undertakings: NTPC Limited, Power Finance Corporation Limited, Rural Electrification Corporation, and Power Grid Corporation of India Limited. And it is South Asia's first and foremost energy efficiency leader, and leads the market related activities of National Mission for Enhanced Energy Efficiency, which is one of the eight missions which are there for National Mission on Prime Minister's National Action Plan on Climate Change. So details is that Unnati Yojana, basically affordable LEDs for all. So please note this, it is important. So this is also covered under Energy Efficiency Services Limited. So you have to broadly consider which of the following points are important. First, you must know that it is a public sector undertaking, and it is joint venture among four public sector undertakings, that is NTPC, Power PFCL, Power Finance Corporation Limited, Rural Electrification Corporation Limited, and Power Grid Corporation of India Limited. and the various schemes are covered by it. For example, your Ujla, that is Unnati Jyoti by affordable LEDs for all. So it is world's largest zero subsidy domestic LED bulb program. And then Street Lightning National Program, world's largest street light replacement program. And then energy, agriculture demand side management, world's largest agriculture demand side management program. And then building energy efficiency program and super efficient AC program. And then let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements related to the proposed development banks. So there is a kind of proposal for development banks, and we have to consider the statements about it. First, it is based on the public-private partnership model. Second, it will provide both short-term and long-term funds. So we have to choose which of the above statements is correct. So let me tell you, friend, that neither of these statements is correct, because it is not the partnership between public-private partnership. It is not based on public-private partnership model. So they will be owned by government, and they will provide only medium. They will only cater the needs of the medium to long-term funds relating to developmental activities of critical areas, for example, agriculture and then housing and infrastructure. So which of the above statements is correct? Neither one nor two. So basically, critical sectors will be supported by it, like agriculture, housing, infrastructure, and industries. So it will ensure the long-term, medium to long-term finance needs, or loans at subsidized rates at to various critical sectors like agriculture, housing, infrastructure, and industries. So it is the importance is that it will be complementing the banking sector, which provides short-term loans, and will also reduce the burden on this banking sector. So it will be mainly owned by the government and will get funding from government issuance and as well as issuance of shares, issuance of long-term bonds, etc. Next is 7th Eastern Economic Forum is in news recently is related to. First, East African event B, Russian government's annual event C, East European initiative. So here is a spelling mistake in European, sorry for that. D is none of the above. So friends, let me tell you that the answer is B, Russian government's annual event. So this Eastern Economic Forum, it was in news because recently the Russian president, that is Vladimir Putin, has invited Indian Prime Minister, that is Narendra Modi, to be a special guest to this event that is scheduled to be taking place in Vladivostok. So basically this event held is held annually in Vladivostok. So the solution is B. So it has been invited as chief guest, not special guest, but chief guest by the Russian President Vladimir Putin. So about the Eastern Economic Forum, the thing is that it was established by decree of the President of Russian Federation Vladimir Putin in 2015. So it takes place in Vladivostok. It serves as a platform for the discussion of key issues in the world economy, regional integration, and development of new industrial and technological sectors, as well as of the global challenges facing Russia and other nations. So it traditionally takes place in the form of panel sessions, roundtables, televised debates, business breakfast, and business dialogues devoted to Russia's relationship with various countries. And forum business program includes a number of business dialogues with leading partner countries in the Asia Pacific region, with Asia a key integration organization of dynamically developing nations in the Southeast Asia. Now let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements related to Pakka Malai Reserve Forest. First, it is in the state of Kerala. Second, Kaveri River divides the forest into two halves. Third, Tarantula, a peacock parachute spider, is recently found in this forest. Fourth, it is present in the Western Ghats region. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you, friend, that first statement is clearly incorrect, because this Pakka Malai Reserve Forest is in Tamil Nadu. So obviously, first statement is incorrect. And when you know that Tamil Nadu, it is in Tamil Nadu, then you must know that there is no question of Western Ghats being there. So obviously, it is not present in Western Ghats region. So it is in fact present in your Eastern Ghats region. So fourth is also correct, and fourth is also incorrect, and second is also incorrect, because there is no such thing that Kaveri River divides the forest into two halves. So third is correct, because Tarantula, that is a form of a spider which is listed as critically endangered. It has been recently found in this forest, and it has been first time that this Tarantula has been found beyond its non-habitat. So let me tell you some facts about Tarantula, that it is basically the species that is critically endangered, and also it is the species is endemic to India. So the solution is See, that is third only. So as I have already told you that this Pakkamalai reserve forest is in your Tamil Nadu, and about species that is endemic to India and it is critically endangered, and it has been first sighted by researchers in this forest in Eastern Ghats. So let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements related to National Digital Library of India. First, it aims to make available digital education resources to all citizens of the country. Second, the project is implemented by Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. So we have to choose that which of these statements are correct about National Digital Library of India. So friends, let me tell you that the first is correct. Yes, it aims to make available digital education resources to all citizens of the country. But the project is not implemented by Ministry of EIT, but it is implemented by Ministry of HRD, that is Human Resource Development. So the answer is A. That is one only. So this is basically a Ministry of HRD is the implementing agency. So it is basically a project of Ministry of Human Resource Development, and it is under the aegis or patronage of National Mission on Education through Information and Communication Technology. So it is developed by IIT Kharagpur. Please note this. This is important. So the objective is to make digital education resources to available to all the citizens of India, so that to empower and inspire and encourage learning. So key facts is that it is a single window platform that collects and collates metadata from premier learning institutions in India and abroad, as well as other relevant sources. So basically this has been envisaged. Please note about this national mission, this scheme, that is National Mission on Education through Information and Communication Technology. So it is a centrally sponsored scheme. So it has two basically objectives, that is to use information and technology in education, and that is to make the use of connectivity and providing the access setup, a provision for access devices to institutions and learners and content generation. So aim is basically to extend computer infrastructure and connectivity to over 25,000 colleges, 2,000 polytechnics in the country, including each of the departments of the 419 universities, deemed universities and institutions of national importance, as a part of its motto to provide connectivity up to last mile. And let's move on to the last question of the day. Last question of the day is, United Nations Convention to Combat Desertification is an outcome of, first, A, Montreal Protocol, B, Minamata Convention, C, Agenda 21, D, none of the above. So we have to choose that which of the statements is correct. So friends, the statement that is correct is C, Agenda 21. So this United Nations Convention to Combat Desertification is an outcome of C, that is Agenda 21. So it is basically, it was established, this Agenda 21 was established in 1994. And it is basically the sole binding international agreement linking environment and development to sustainable land management. So then there is UNCCD 2018 to 2030 strategic framework and most comprehensive global commitment to achieve land degradation neutrality. So basically, as you know that the dynamics of the climate change, the land, and then your biodiversity are intimately connected. So this United Nations Convention to Combat Desertification, it works closely with other two conventions, that is other two Rio conventions, that is UNFCCC, and then your this convention on your biological diversity. So, but please note that this is very important. This may be asked in UPSC, because UPSC has the habit to confuse you in the questions. So it closely works with this. So you must be knowing that obviously land is related with climate change. If there is climate change, then there is heating taking place, and then obviously land will be affected. And then when land will be affected, the biodiversity that is dependent upon it, that is linked with it, will obviously be affected, because the lithosphere is an important part of the biodiversity. So as you know that biodiversity basically exists in the three regions, that is lithosphere, hydrosphere and atmosphere. So where these three regions coincide, there is biodiversity there, it closely works with this Convention on Biological Diversity and United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. So friends, this is all about today's discussion about the MCQ. So if you like the video, if you like that discussion, then do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. And lastly friends, an important information for you is
is that if in case you want to stay updated about our various initiatives, then you can contact us at our Telegram, you can join our Telegram channel, public Telegram channel, the link of which is shown on your screen, and this will also be provided in the description box, so that you can join with our community, so that you can remain updated about various initiatives that we have taken for mains as well as prelims for the purpose of CSE. And lastly, if in case you want to subscribe to the PDFs of these MCQs, then you can mail us at achieveias21@gmail.com, or you can also contact us at 8968920720. So if in case you are interested, but let me tell you, friends, that obviously there is a minimum cost for this subscription of PDFs, that is rupees 99 per month. So that this fees has been kept for the purpose of your affordability as well as for the purpose of our motivation, so that we can remain motivated to help you people. So if in case you are interested in PDFs, then you can contact us, or you can directly subscribe to the link by subscribe to this initiative of PDFs by using the link that will be given there in the description box. So this is all about our today's video. Do ensure that you check the description box if in case you want to join this initiative for the PDF. So this is all about today's video. Do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. So thank you. Have a very nice day ahead.